We're getting a sobering new update on the threat posed by Vladimir Putin's military buildup. Our Pentagon correspondent, Barbara Starr, spoke with the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff earlier in the day. Barbara, what did he tell you?
Well, Wolf, tonight, the number one general in the U.S. military increasingly concerned about both Russian and Chinese military buildups.
A U.S. B-52 bomber caught on a Russian aircraft camera over the Baltic Sea. Moscow claims a Russian fighter jet forced the Americans to back off, something adamantly denied by the U.S. Air Force, which said the Russian aircraft did not chase the B-52 away. It's all part of the new front line between Moscow and Washington over superpower dominance. The chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff says Russia is working on new missiles, ships, and aircraft aimed at making it harder for the U.S. to defend Europe, a plan, he says, that is so far succeeding.
There's absolutely no question that it'd be more difficult for us to project power in Europe today.
General Joseph Dunford says the U.S. can still defend Europe, and the Pentagon is funding new U.S. weapons to push back. But he has an unusually blunt warning about Russian President Vladimir Putin.
We're talking about Putin putting together information operations, cyber operations, economic coercion, political influence, unconventional military operations to advance his objectives.
Dunford also pinning the 2016 election interference on Putin, something President Trump has not done, even as the U.S. intelligence community believes it.
Putin is doing things, he did things in the United States in the context of the 2016 elections to try to undermine our democracy. I make an assumption that there's very little that Russia does that Putin is not aware of.
And on the China front, General Dunford expressed very deep concern about American high-tech companies doing business in China, that their technology would be directed towards the Chinese military. He has singled out again Google for his concerns about this. And we're now learning that General Dunford next week here in Washington plans to meet with top Google executives at their request to discuss his concerns about China.
Yeah,
Wolf?
Very serious concerns indeed. Barbara Starr, thanks very much. Tonight, the Pentagon is denying Russia's claim that its fighter jets chased away an American B-52 bomber over the Baltic Sea. Our senior international correspondent, Fred Plykin, is joining us live from Moscow with details. Fred, the U.S. military says there was what it calls a routine interaction between the planes, but Russia is painting the encounter as something much more serious.
Hey, you're absolutely right, Wolf. And what we're seeing is Russian TV really going after the United States and the Russian government, quite frankly, as well. They're calling this an escalation and a provocation, where the U.S. says it's a necessary deterrent. Here's what's going on.
Tonight, Russia lashing out at the U.S. after claiming Russian jets intercepted a nuclear-capable B-52 bomber over the Baltic Sea. A Kremlin spokesman saying America is risking an escalation in Eastern Europe.
Such actions of the United States do not lead to strengthening the atmosphere of security and stability in the region that is directly adjacent to the borders of the Russian Federation. On the contrary, this probably adds more tension. We regret such actions of Washington.
Russia claims it scrambled Su-27 interceptor jets. Russian state TV even showing a graphic claiming the Russian warplanes chased the B-52 away. The U.S. Air Force denies that claim, saying, quote, the B-52 had a routine interaction with the Russian Su-27 while conducting operations over the Baltic Sea. The pilots were using transponders and operating in conformity with international law. The Russian aircraft did not chase the B-52 away, and the bomber was able to complete its mission. The U.S. has recently deployed 6 of the B-52s to the European theater, a move apparently meant to send a message to a resurgent Russia. The Pentagon saying Moscow has been building up its forces and increasingly becoming more aggressive on NATO's doorstep. The Russian Air Force recently flying their own supersonic Tu-22 M3 bombers over the Black Sea. And while President Trump and Vladimir Putin both say they still want to improve U.S.-Russian relations, Moscow accusing the U.S. of risking a nuclear war. Russia's deputy foreign minister saying, quote, the threshold for the use of nuclear weapons is decreasing due to a newly adopted strategy in the United States, which blurs the line between national conflict and war with the use of nuclear weapons. The U.S., for its part, says Russia has long been violating nuclear non-proliferation treaties and says Moscow needs to tone down its rhetoric and its posture.
And Moscow certainly not toning down its rhetoric. Of course, Vladimir Putin in the past couple of weeks and months praising Russia's new classes of nuclear-capable weapons. But certainly, as we've seen the past days, at least the U.S. Air Force not backing down.
Yeah, serious situation indeed. Fred Pleitgen in Moscow for us. Thanks very much.